Hello, ancient civilization buffs. My name is Camille Sauvé, author of the book Sorcerers of Stone, Architects of the Three Ages. And today I have a highly controversial, if not actually taboo, subject that I would like to have a conversation about. You might be asking yourself, whatever can be that controversial when examining ancient sites? And I have to say, it is the subject of geopolymers, which is a type of concrete that they use to make artificial rocks. This geopolymer topic alone gets more people riled up because it completely goes against what mainstream archaeologists claim of how ancient stone constructions were formed. And that was by using primitive tools like bronze tools and pounding stones. For those of you unfamiliar with the word geopolymer, it is essentially a type of concrete, either synthetic or organic, which hardens over time. Unlike modern concrete, which tends to weaken and break up in a few decades, most geopolymers have a long life, and some, like Roman concrete, even get harder over time. Though many would like to say that the ancients couldn't have used geopolymers as it is an alien tech, today geopolymers are used in many industries, including the building trades and in the arts. Even though we can make them today, it is often frowned upon and ridiculed if you imply that the ancients were using them to create their ancient sites. But why? Were the ancients not capable of simple chemistry? We can also see that there are big dimples where it looks like some logs were pushed into the matrix when it was soft, possibly to hold the shape together while it was curing. Another thing to consider is that if the stone was soft at one time, like the consistency of modeling clay, this would explain how the massive polygonal stones could be fitted so precisely into one another. For instance, while one was hardening or hardened, a softer matrix was put in adjacent to the hardened one, which would conform to the edges of its mate. This would, of course, explain the perfectly fitted joinery that one sees on the megalithic sites. As fascinating as the megalithic sites are, I find the even more bizarre remnants of the mother culture, known in Peru as the Hanan Pacha culture, even stranger. These sites are monoliths, or giant stone monuments, that are frequently buried below the megalithic constructions. These kinds of sites are so bizarre that they seem truly alien. With them, we can often see fingerprints pushing into the matrix to make unnatural ledges, canals, basins, and other exotic forms. There are also strange depressions that seem like odd footprints. Okay, you may be asking yourself, am I nuts? Maybe. Many people would say so, but before you judge me too harshly, let's look at the video evidence and let that speak for itself. Here I look at the site of Qochaapata in the foothills of Sacsayhuamán Park. And right below Qochaapata, which is right above Kenco Chico, we see more remnants of Hanan Pacha rock. We can really see here how the Inca built around this rock with their own temples and buildings. They recognized it as sacred and they wanted to build right next to these sites to honor the ancestors. But what were these built for? Wow, look at that. Amazing.
almost looks like one giant footprint. Though I don't know if that's what that is, but it is very smooth inside, as opposed to the surface of the rock, which is pretty much rough and full of grooves. Here we can see, again, what looks like fingerprints pushing up the matrix to form some kind of a ledge. Especially right here, it just looks like Play-Doh.
On the subject of the fluid nature and strange striations on the rock, some have suggested that these were caused by acid rain or exposure to the elements. However, I have a hard time believing that acid rain could cause this damage, as the rocks that have these forms and ridges are right next to others with no or very minimal surface damage on the stone. Can acid rain or even exposure to the elements be that selective? Then we have the case of the Russian geologists who were invited by the Ministry of Culture in 2012 to examine the site of Sacsayhuamán for restorative solutions. It was they who examined both the megalithic and the Hanan Pacha rock under electron microscopes and saw that the formed stones and the quarried rock were composed differently. It turned out that the matrix of the shaped stones had a microcrystalline uniformity with no fossils, while all of the quarried rock showed the normal microorganisms common in limestone rock. All of this indicated to them that the rock from the quarry went under some type of processing to give it the conformity of structure not represented in the quarried stone. When the geologists presented this to scientists in Peru, they said that they thought the stones that made up the archaeological site of Sacsayhuamán were made from geopolymers. Though this caused a bit of disagreement in the room, it did seem like many were open to this information. However, from what I understand, the Russian team was not invited back to Peru to do further investigation into the stone's composition. We can ask ourselves why they weren't invited back. However, my suspicion is that mainstream archaeology is intent on staying with the official narrative in Peru, and that this is that the colossal stones were quarried, carried, sometimes many miles to the site, and then cut to fit to puzzle-perfect perfection with the simple tools that they had. Of course, we can debate this theory to the condors fly home, but all I can say is why go to all that incredible, hard, and time-consuming work when constructing the temples when geopolymers would make that work so much easier? Anyways, internet friends, I hope this gives you something to ponder and wonder over. And I would like to ask that if you really enjoy this type of content and would like to see more videos like this, then please subscribe and leave your comments. I would love to hear your feedback, whether it's good, bad, or ugly. Although, I would like to say, let's be willing to explore these mysteries with an open mind and with respect to one another. Blessings to all, and happy travels.